The indigenous people of Japan have always believed that walking through the forest and breathing in the air is beneficial to your health. It is called Shinrin Yoku. Shinrin means forest and yoku means bathing.
This is Health and Weather Extended, and today we are going to talk about the ancient Japanese tradition of forest bathing. Think about cleansing your mind and rejuvenating yourself as you slowly walk through the forest. It sounds simple, but there really is a right way to do it.
Forest bathing is a leisurely walk through the forest, taking in the whole forest atmosphere with your senses. If you spend enough of time in the forest and you come away with a sense of awe afterwards, you know that you've done it right. For the Japanese, they recommend that you walk for 2 hours over a 2.5 kilometer distance. If you have more time, double that up to 4 hours for a 5 kilometer distance.
And there's some signs in when you are forest bathing that you know that you're on the right track. You will start to feel your heart rate slow down. You'll start to feel your shoulders drop a little bit. You'll notice that you breathe a little more deeply. You'll also notice that, you know, worrying becomes something that just doesn't happen. We really find the present moment, and nature really helps us sink into that.
For some, it's hard to wrap your head around thinking of the forest as your therapist. However, studies have shown this works, especially for people who deal with depression. A study out of Japan took 155 people between the ages of 18 and 60 and introduced them to various forest bathing sessions over 3 years. About 37% of these participants had depressive tendencies. Through each forest bathing session, blood pressure and profile of mood was recorded. The study concluded that after examining the physiological and psychological effects of a day-long session of forest bathing on a working-age group, it demonstrated significant positive effects on mental health, especially for those with depressive tendencies. The report also mentioned that all participants recorded a significant decrease in blood pressure after a session of forest bathing. Now, another important health element is what we get from the phytoncides.
Forest air accounts for 50% of the benefits of forest bathing. This is because trees filter out pollution. They also produce oxygen. But more importantly, they produce a substance, a volatile organic compound called phytoncides. This is also able to be stored in the resin of the trees. And this is the tree's immune system. It fights off bacteria, fungi, insects. And when you are breathing that air, it helps to build your immune system as well. Evergreen trees produce the most significant type and quantity of phytoncides, but broadleaf trees also produce them.
Forest medicine suggests that we may have more access to these phytoncides in the fall, especially when these leaves are on the ground and they're closer to us. So the fall could be an optimal time to enjoy forest bathing.
Often a lot of the coniferous trees that have the sap running will give off that smell, that beautiful pinene smell, the phytoncides, right? And as we inhale that, that stops our cortisol production, which is our stress hormone. So it really quickly brings us into calmness. Also, of course, with the colors changing and the different fractals that we see, that's also something else that really soothes us and helps us put our worries aside.
You can try forest bathing solo or with an instructor. This has been Health and Weather Extended. Thanks for joining me on this walk through the forest.